Hey dudes, what's up? Oh man, I keep getting this request over and over again, so I'm gonna finally do it. I don't know how good I am gonna be at doing this stuff. I'm not, as far as comparing weapons, I'm not like real, that is something Nothing Fancy is good at, depending on what he says, but he's real thorough that way. And a couple other guys out there. That are pretty good at comparing weapons. This is a request. Everyone's asking me, can you compare the XD with the Glock side by side? So I said, okay, I don't know. And then another guy asked me, another guy asked me. I said, okay, well, so I'm doing it now. And see what we can do for with the time we got. This is a Glock 22. The magazines are loaded. But there's nothing in the chamber, but we're going to check anyway. This is a Glock 22, it's a 40 caliber. This is a Springfield XD, it's a 40 caliber. They're both around the same size. The Glock's a little bit longer, maybe a quarter of an inch longer. Okay, we're going to safety check the weapons. There's nothing in the Glock. Okay, I must have emptied it. See? That's what I'm talking about. XD is loaded because I had it by my bed nightstand last night. And that's it. Okay, let's compare these two. Let's compare them. Well, what do you want to look at first? How do you want to compare them? How about, let's look at the safeties first. Okay, let's start with the safety. Let's go with the XD. And let's start with the Glock. The Glock safety, the Glock has three safeties. Okay? There's the drop firing pin safety. There's a block in there. If you drop the gun, there's a block stops the firing pin from going off. There's also a trigger safety, which is just here. This little lever in between the trigger. You must engage that and the trigger at the same time to pull the trigger. And the last safety, it has three safeties, is the trigger position you're seeing right now we're looking at. See, it's in the rear position. It's letting you know before you even grab the gun that the gun is in a safe position. It cannot be fired. Okay? What's pretty neat about the Glock safety is when you're pulling the trigger, all the safeties react as you're pulling the trigger. It's like one motion mechanism. It makes all three safeties activate at once. It's pretty cool. Okay, as far as that goes. Now let's go to the XD side. The XD safeties. Well, I'm not used to doing these overhead. First, you got a grip safety, which is nice. You know, do you need it? I don't know. Probably not, but it's nice to have. Second, you got the trigger safety like the Glock. The one that's in the middle. It's the same kind of thing. The trigger will not go back unless you pull it back and engage that. It will not go back. Okay? There's another safety. And the other safety is, to me, these are safeties. It has a decocking indicator, which is a safety. Which I'll show you. Take the mag out. And when you pull the trigger, you'll see the decocking pin disappear. That just shows you the gun's cocked. That's another safety. And it also has I'm not with it today, man. I'm fucked up. A chamber indicator on the top. See that little slit? When you put a round in the chamber, that will pop up to show you there is a round in the chamber. Does a Glock have a round in the chamber indicator? It does, but I don't consider that a round indicator. When there's a round in here, this the extractor here will stick out a little bit. You know, if you know your gun well, you can tell by looking at it. But to me, it don't stick out enough. You have to feel with your finger, and even that I'm not comfortable with. So does it have a chamber indicator? Not really. If you look in here, in this crack here, you can see brass, if there's a round in there. Really. So, you know, the Glock does not have a chamber indicator. It's not, it doesn't, and not a protruding one anyway. Okay. So, as far as safeties go, I think the XD's got the heavier side. But the Glock has a really unique trigger. That is neat that all three safeties are within that trigger pull and the drop safety. How about features? Well, the XD's got the grip safety, the trigger safety, the cocking indicator, the chamber indicator, the ambidextrous mag releases on both sides, and also the trigger's metal. To me, that's a feature, that the trigger's metal, because most polymer guns, the triggers are plastic, even HKs and all the other polymer guns. This has a steel guide spring rod. It comes with it stock. This, you have to buy it separately, but it comes with a plastic one. So to me, that's a feature. Steel guide spring rod. Okay, now the Glock features are not much. Trigger safety, drop safety, and the rear position safety, they're features. And it has the Tiffinier finish. It has a special Tiffinier finish for the elements. These are probably great guns, like if you're a cop, them cops up, state troopers up in Alaska, I think they use Glocks. And this finish will hold up to the elements. And the Glock has a polygonal barrel, which is very, very, very accurate. It's kind of like rifling, it's a little different. It's just a really accurate way to design a gun barrel. Don't know too much about it, that's all I can tell you. I just know it's good. Magazines, well, the Glock holds 15. This is what the big thing is with Glock over all guns, the magazine capacity. It's amazing how they design their magazines. The magazine holds 15 in a Glock, and the Springfield XD holds 12. Okay? The Glock wins on that side. As far as weight goes, the Glock is a little lighter than the Springfield XD. But depending on who you are, you might like a little weight like me. See, for me, the Springfield wins because I like something just a little bit heavier. Now, to a guy that likes a real light guns, the Glock would win with that. You know, but neither guns are heavy. You're talking only a few ounce difference. This just feels like it has something more to it. It feels like you get more for your money. Just, it's a psychological thing. And, you know, I'm weird, so I need to feel a little weight. Okay, so as far as weight goes, the Glock's lighter. How about appearance? Well, appearance, the Glock, well, this Glock isn't. Most Glocks are very plain, you know. This Glock's kind of cool looking because it has them new serrations on it. And what I love about them new serrations, the way they're designed is awesome. I can rack this slide so fucking fast you wouldn't believe it. It's because of them serrations. Now, I couldn't do that with my other Glock because it has the regular serrations and they're a pain in the ass. So I do like the serrations on the Glock. Very, very nice. The serrations on this makes it pretty difficult to pull it back. You really got to pay attention. You got to get a good hold on it to rack to slide. But it has a really tense recoil spring, so you got to get a really good hold on it. So I like the Glock serrations as far as speed goes. But looks overall, the XD wins hands down. It's just a better looking gun. It has a lot of style to it. It's beefier looking. It looks like a beast, you know, and guys like that. And does that mean anything? Sure it does. Men are visual human beings, okay, most of us. So what sells the XD a lot is the way it looks too. It's a badass looking gun. I mean, come on, look at the difference. Look at this and look at this. This is very slim and plain, and you know, it's an awesome gun, but this has a lot more style and character. It's just beefier looking, and it's beautiful. The machine work is just fucking off the hook. The Glock, as far as machine work goes, I don't know. I mean, there's not much machine work there. Okay, you got a drill press that goes in here and goes, you know, it's CMC units, whatever. That's all. I mean, there's really barely any machine work in here, but the Springfield has a lot of beautiful machine work in it. But with the Glock's reputation in defense of the Glock, it's simple. It's a simple operating gun. All right, we're running out of time already. Performance, as far as performance goes, both guns are the same. They're both accurate, and they're neck and neck with each other. They are, you know, to me, one's not better than the other. So, in all says, you know, both guns are great. Not one's better than the other. One just looks a little better than the other. And one has a few more features. That's all I got time for, guys. I'll see you later.